Thank you, Cam Corder.
Thank you.
Taoiseach, the Fianna Fáil government bankrupted this country, making a decision in the early hours of the morning, as we now know, under the diktats of the ECB. Now, tonight, in the same sort of circumstances, your government is also taking a decision about one of the main culprits in the financial crisis in this country and vast amounts of money under the diktats of the ECB. Just as took place then. The ECB says jump, and this government says how high, even if it means trampling on the democracy of this House and the rights of the citizens to know and scrutinise what you are planning and proposing for them, along with your friends in the ECB. The suggestion that you are ramming through this bill as a result of an unintended leak is an insult to the intelligence of this House and the people. I suggested at leaders' questions on Tuesday that you were engaged in an elaborate charade with the spectacle of the tarnished going around Chile, talking about the government collapsing, Minister White talking about the Croke Park deal collapsing, and you were smiling like Cheshire cats, just as you have been all week and still are, saying there was nothing up. But tonight's events clearly confirm this is the second act in a play, in amateur dramatics that started earlier this week and which will conclude tomorrow, when the deal you have already planned, just as this legislation was clearly written some time ago, wasn't written today, some time ago, to ram this through in order to pin Anglo's gambling debts permanently, securely, legally to the backs of the Irish people in such a way as that we cannot repudiate them. And people are saying this is about giving the minister powers, as this does. It's not just about giving the minister powers. This actually is the action which pins the debts to our back, because now we owe the money to the European Central Bank as a result of this bill.
Thank you. Deputy Higgins, thank you.
And I would just say, finally, it's no coincidence this thing ran through when you know tens of thousands of people are taking to the streets this weekend demanding that you lift the burden.
Thank you.
I would urge the people out there who you are trying to hoodwink, the nurses, the teachers, the guards, to take to the streets against this disgraceful attempt to hoodwink them and unload Anglo's gambling debts onto their banks.
I'm afraid you only have 7 minutes left between the other two speakers.